We are calling this the MQFF show because it's the Melbourne Queer Film Festival. Starts on the 15th of March and was launched this week. Lisa Daniel is the festival director and, we can give you the credit or the blame for curating the program.
Yeah, speak to me after March 26. I'll decide whether I should leave the country or whether I should hang around.
There's a lot of film there. Short films, feature films, documentaries. We talked with Grant about The Wilding, which is a short film in the Oz Shorts package on the second weekend. And we're about to talk to a film producer. I'm pretty impressed by that role. I think it sounds like a lot of hard work. It does sound smart. Helen Kelly has worked with Heather Corkill on The Cure. Are you there, Helen?
Hi, good morning.
And hello to you. Thank you for joining us on Joy 94.9. Lisa's going to ask you all the really intelligent questions about producing a documentary.
Hey, Heather, how are you? Sorry, Helen.
It's Heather is the director. Yeah.
Yes,
how are you doing?
we did discuss that 25 times before I said that. Now tell me, how is the screening? Is there a screening up in Sydney this week?
That's right, yes. The Cure will make its premiere this weekend at the Mardi Gras Film Festival.
Fantastic. Is that the world premiere?
That's right. We do like to say that term quite a bit at the moment. It's very exciting.
I know, it's pretty cool, isn't it?
So we're
getting the Melbourne premiere on the 24th of
March.
Which would be great.
So it's not about the rock band, is it?
No, and a word of the wise to all up-and-coming filmmakers, make sure you Google the title of your film before you decide about pitching it everywhere.
But, oh, really? Why? Yeah. Tell us what happened.
Well, we just, we kind of spontaneously came up with the name way, way, way back in the research stage, and it just sort of stuck, and we didn't really think about it, and we plugged ahead, and we realised that people were latching on to the title as a means of finding us on the internet. And then we realised that it would be pretty hard to find us because we're buried amongst all things relating to the band. So, that was probably our first major mistake. But we've managed to recover somewhat since then.
Well, let's hope that you sort of, you know, by far outstay the band. The film might be around for decades. Do you want to tell us a little bit about what the film is about?
Sure. The Cure is an exploration of reparative programs, more commonly known as ex-gay programs in Australia. And particularly we wanted to look at the mental health implications of trying to change one's sexual orientation or identity. So essentially the film explores the story of six main protagonists who have all undergone different kinds of reparative therapy in an attempt to reorientate their sexuality. Five of those people had no success, and one man believes that he has undergone a transformation from homosexual to heterosexual.
Now, he's the guy that runs his own ministry, is that correct?
That's correct. He runs Living Waters.
Living Waters, that's right, yeah.
That's right, and they are probably the major player in reparative programs in Australia, if you exclude online programs.
And have the participants seen the film yet?
Yes, we have had the opportunity to show most of our participants the film. You know, it was a difficult process for all of them, obviously, and particularly some of them are still very close to that experience. It's not so much in the distant past for them, so I think it was pretty difficult, but they're all, you know, incredibly supportive of what we're doing, and they're very courageous people, all of them, so we really appreciate, you know, the time and energy they've put into it.
And what about the guy from Living Waters? What was his response?
Ron hasn't seen the final cut yet. As a part of... we found it very difficult to encourage someone, essentially from the other side of the fence, someone who is sort of promoting ex-gay programs and is a supporter. We found it really hard to get somebody to actually come on camera and speak with us.
Yep, I can imagine.
So one of the conditions that we agreed to was that they had the right to review footage before we went to editing, and they had an opportunity at that point to withdraw anything that they weren't comfortable with. So that's the stage that Ron's seen. He's seen all of his interview. He's aware of, you know, what could possibly make it into the film, and he was comfortable with that, and that's where we're at with him.
Yeah. Well, that's fascinating because, you know, that other side of the story really makes the film have that sort of breadth that you need to have two sides of the story, really, doesn't it?
Absolutely. I mean, it was absolutely our intention when we set out not to make an aggressive film that was about demonising anybody. We really just wanted to explore the issues at hand and try and understand for ourselves why anybody would want to submit themselves to this kind of really intense emotional, you know, psychological kind of program. So the fact that Ron was prepared to come on camera and speak with us was our ultimate goal. We absolutely wanted to try and present both sides of the story so the audience has an opportunity to make up their own mind.
Yeah, you've done it really well. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much.
How did you come up with the idea to do the film in the first place? Is it a personal journey for you and Heather?
No. Actually, we were inspired by an 8-minute piece that was screened on Hungry Beast that really briefly just looked at the fact that these programs exist in Australia, and we were all really quite shocked. We thought it was a very, you know, much more of an American thing. We didn't realise that it was actually taking place in modern day Australia. So we started talking about it, and we were just really fascinated. We're at the Brisbane Queer Film Festival, actually, at the Powerhouse there, just sitting around having a chat about this really fascinating piece and just saying, we just want to know more about this. We want to explore this more deeply. We really feel like there's so much more to tell, and we just started looking into it, and then one thing led to another, and the next thing we know, we're filming at Mardi Gras with the Freedom to Be group marching, you know. So it was just a natural progression that just kept rolling on.
And it seems to have come full circle if you're part of the Mardi Gras Film Festival this weekend.
Yes. Absolutely. And we do have the great honour of being screened at the Brisbane Queer Film Festival as well, so in April. So it absolutely will come full circle for us at that moment as well.
Fantastic. Helen, thank you for chatting with us about The Cure. If you put The Cure documentary into your search engine, Helen's right, you might get a bit of Robert Smith, but you'll also get something about this great documentary that'll be screening at the Melbourne Queer Film Festival on the 24th of March.
That's right, correct.
Yep.
And a bit of a Q&A as well, straight after. So we're screening the film, and then we're going to have a Q&A with, I think, Heather.
That's right, yes.
Fantastic.
Thank you, Helen.
Thank you so much.
Joy 94.9.
The MQFF 2012 show, presented by proud media partner of Melbourne Queer Film Festival, Joy 94.9.
Don't miss this year's centrepiece presentations, sponsored by the Australian Centre for the Moving Image at the Melbourne Queer Film Festival, March 15 to 25. See mqff.com.au for full program details, ticket outlet info and secure web bookings. Joy 94.9 is a proud media partner for MQFF 2012.